إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله عز وجل به الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. اللهم اجزه عنا خير ما جزيت نبيا عن أمته ورسولا عن رسالته. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Today, inshallah, we will learn, by the permission of Allah Azza wa Jal, how to deal with hardships and how to behave when we are facing calamities and issues and challenges and problems. Because it is important to look for answers within our deen. Because deen al-Islam is a perfect religion. It has answers for everything. Look at today's khutbah as a consultation with Quran and Sunnah. The good thing about it, it's free. You don't have to pay. All we have to do is make the effort to learn. And the information is out there. So since we're here, let's all benefit bi-idhnillah from our deen and learn how to deal with calamities. But number one, let's all agree that tests, trials, misfortunes are one of the laws of Allah Azza wa Jalla in His creations. Al-ibtila, la budda minhu. It will definitely take place. However, that trial that you go through is different from one person to the other. It's not the same for everyone. However, it is imperative that we are well equipped. That way, we don't say something that will make Allah Azza wa Jalla upset with us. We won't do something that we will regret later on. فالله عز وجل يقول في سورة العنكبوت بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون. Do people think that they're gonna be left alone because they said we believe and they will not be put through the test? Allah Azza wa Jalla says in Surah Al-Mulk: الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. The one who created death and life, Allah Azza wa Jal. For what reason? لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ, to test us. But the test will definitely happen. Allah Azza wa Jalla says in Surah Al-Insan: إِنَّا خَلَقَنَا الْإِنسَانَ من نطفة أمشاج نبتلي. We will be tested. Now, how we react to the test? That's the question we need to learn the answer for it. And in order to do so, we go back to our deen. We all agree that we will be tested regardless of the background, regardless of the color, regardless of the age, regardless of your social status, you will be tested. So let's prepare ourselves. That way we know what to do when we are dealing with any type of stress or misfortune. The second thing we will mention, inshallah, which will lead us to learn how to do that. قول شريح القاضي رحمه الله. شريح الراجح من أقوال أهل العلم أنه تابعي وليس بصحابي. He's tabi'i, meaning the generation that came after the companions, may Allah be pleased with them. However, he did embrace Islam while the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was still in Medina. Al-Imam al-Sha'bi rahimahullah yaqul qala shuraih inni la'usabu bil musibah فأحمد الله عليها أربع مرات. أحمده إذ لم تكون أعظم مما هي، وأحمده إذ رزقني الصبر عليها، وأحمده إذ وفقني للاسترجاع لما أرجو فيه من الثواب، وأحمده إذ لم تكن في ديني. This is what we're going to be studying. Shuraih rahimahullah was a judge for more than 60 years. Imagine. And he was the first Muslim judge in Al-Kufa. He was appointed by Umar radiyallahu anhu when he was the Khalifa. Wa kana ma'rufan bi'ilmih wa wara'ih wa zuhdih وحكمته ورزانته وذكائه. He was known for his knowledge, known for his justice, known for his wisdom, known for his patience. And that's what's required from someone to be a judge. He said, when I'm being tested, look, the first thing he says, Ahmadullah. He said, I praise and thank Allah Azza wa Jalla. Can you imagine when he's being tested, instead of complaining, instead of crying out, instead of doing something bad, he is praising Allah Azza wa Jalla and thanking him. Right there, it shows you that Islam came to change the perspectives. The way we look at things is different in Islam. But you know why he said that? There are reasons why. We'll mention some of them, inshallah. He said, I thank Allah Azza wa Jalla and praise Him 4 times. Why? He said the first one, أحمده إذ لم تكن أعظم مما هي. I thank Allah Azza wa Jalla for the fact that that hardship is not worse than what it is. Abdullah, this is the first thing that should come to our mind when we're being tested. It could have been a lot worse, but the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jalla is showering us all the time. No wonder why he said in Surah An-Nur, لَا تَحْسَبُوهُ شَرًّا لَكُمْ بَلْ هُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. Don't consider it as something bad for you. Actually, it's good. And Allah Azza wa Jalla also says in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَعَسَى أَن تَكْرَهُ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. It might or it may be that you dislike something, but actually it's good for you. So when you're being tested with something negative, the first thing you think about is, it could be worse than this. Actually, think of it that it's good for you. You just don't see it. And how many things we like them, but they turn out to be very bad for us. Why? Because Allah Azza wa Jalla knows and we don't know. And that's how Allah Azza wa Jalla ends the ayah. وَعَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌّ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Trust Allah Azza wa Jalla. Even if the calamity seems so bad, just trust Allah Azza wa Jalla. And think about it, could be worse. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كَمَا ثَبَتَ عِنْدَ التِّرْمِذِي حَدِيثَ أَبِي هُرَيْرَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ قَالَ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ انظُرُوا إِلَى مَنْ أَسْفَلَ مِنْكُمْ وَلَا تَنظُرُوا إِلَى مَنْ فَوْقَكُمْ لِأَلَّا تَزْدَرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. You want to be grateful to Allah Azza wa Jal, despite you being tested with something that seems very bad to you. Look at those who are less fortunate than you. When your car breaks down, look at those who don't even have a car. When your house has issues, look at those who don't even have a shelter. Look at those who live in tents. So when you look at those who are less fortunate than you, you end up being a grateful servant. Then you realize that you are lucky. Then you are fortunate and you are blessed. Instead of complaining, you thank Allah Azza wa Jalla. That's why Shuraih rahimahullah is telling us, when the calamity hits, thank Allah Azza wa Jalla that it's not worse than that. And what is the second thing? He said rahimahullah, Ahmadullah alayha, aw Ahmadullah idh razaqani as-sabra alayha. This is important. Patience, brothers and sisters. When you're being tested, remind yourself of patience. Patience is wajib. وَالْرِضَى مُسْتَحَبْ زَائِد. Patience is an obligation. When you're being tested, make sure that you are patient. Allah Azza wa Jalla يقول في سورة البقرة وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقَصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ. We will certainly test you. Then he subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions five things. Al-khawf, fear, joy, hunger, naqs, decrease in what? In wealth, in souls, in fruits. Then immediately says, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Give the good news, the glad tidings to who? To those who have patience. فَعَبْدَاللَّهِ, if you find yourself patient when you're being tested, thank Allah Azza wa Jal. Because when you thank Allah Azza wa Jal, يَحْفَظُ النِّعْمَةِ. شُكْرُ اللَّهِ يَحْفَظُ النِّعْمَةِ. When you thank Allah Azza wa Jal, He will preserve your blessing for you. Add to that, He will increase it for you. وَإِتَّأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. Allah Azza wa Jalla gave us a promise. If we were to show gratitude, He will give us more. He will increase the blessing for us. فَعَبْدَاللَّهِ, let's remind ourselves of patience when we're being tested. Just like the scholars divided patience into three categories. الصبر على الطاعة والصبر على المعصية والصبر على الأقدار المؤلمة أي المصائب والشدائد. Patience, three types or three levels. One, when it comes to the obedience of Allah Azza wa Jal. The second one, when it comes to the sins. You need to be patient in order not to sin. That requires patience from us. And then patience when we're being tested with hardship and calamities. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه غفور رحيم. بسم الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Dear brothers and sisters, A quick recap of what we just mentioned. Allah Azza wa Jal made it one of His laws to test every single human being. The test will take place, la mahala, no question about it, no doubt. Now the question is how we deal with the test as believers. And so far we said the believer, when he's being tested, he should still praise and thank Allah Azza wa Jal for the fact that the hardship is not worse than what it is. No wonder why Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah, he used to say, لَيْسَ بِفَقِيهٍ مَنْ لَمْ يَعُدَّ الْبَلَاءَ نِعْمَةً وَالرَّخَاءَ مُصِيبَةً. Sufyan al-Thawri, one of the greatest scholars of hadith, may Allah have mercy on him, he used to say, he's not a wise man, he's not someone who truly gets it, the one who does not consider hardship as a blessing from Allah Azza wa Jal. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Where are we from there? When we get tested in the least way, flat tire, we start cursing, yelling, screaming, swearing, doing things that you cannot even imagine. Flat tire, for God's sake. We get a bad news that your business didn't have much income that day, and you start screaming and complaining. Why? Remember, it's a test from Allah Azza wa Jal. It's a test. The one who does not consider tests, trials, hardships as a blessing from Allah. Because how many times you find yourself far away from Allah Azza wa Jal, but when He puts you through the test, that's when you start going to the masjid. That's when you start reading Quran. That's when you start telling the imam and the sheikh, please include me in your dua. That's when you start looking at the umrah packages. Because you want to go and thank Allah Azza wa Jalla and invoke Him in al-haram. Why? Because of that test that Allah Azza wa Jalla had put you through. But when things are going your way, when things are going smooth for you, you don't pray on time, you don't go to the masjid, you don't read Quran, and you don't go to collect good deeds, visiting the sick, attending the janais and all that. But it's only when we're being tested. Look at one of us, when he gets the phone from his doctor, the phone call from his doctor. I'm sorry, I have bad news for you. What happened? You have such and such disease. All of a sudden you go to Google and you start looking it up. How many years, or how long someone who has this disease will live? And all of a sudden you find yourself giving sadaqah. You find yourself going for hajj because you've been delaying it. So imagine if Allah Azza wa Jalla did not put you through that test, you will still be complacent and you will still take it for granted. That's why it's important that we look at hardships as a blessing from Allah Azza wa Jal. Because He's sending us wake-up calls. The third one He said, rahimahullah, وَأَحْمَدُ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلْ إِذْ وَفَّقَنِي لِلْإِسْتِرْجَاءِ. And I thank Allah Azza wa Jalla for the fact that He gave me tawfiq to say الاسترجاء, which is إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Same ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah Azza wa Jalla continues saying, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ. Who are the patient ones? The one when they're being inflicted with something bad, something evil, something negative. قَالُوا. What they say? You don't hear them cursing, swearing, punching the dashboard of his car, screaming at his wife on the phone, slapping his kids, breaking the plates, you name it. That's us, isn't it? But let's change that behavior. Let's try our best to represent our deen the way we're supposed to. When something bad comes to you, the first thing you want to remember is mentioning Allah Azza wa Jal. What they say? Inna lillah. وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. We belong to Allah Azza wa Jalla, and to Allah we shall return. Have you ever thought about the virtue, the excellence, and the benefit of making a such statement when you say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un? Listen to the rest of the ayah. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, Ulaika alayhim salawatun min rabbihim wa rahma wa ulaika humul muhtadun. Ar-Rahma. Salatullah Azza wa Jal wa rahma wal hidayah. When you say, Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Allah Azza wa Jalla will praise you. Brothers, please move forward. I'm being told that there is more people coming, more brothers coming. And I hope that they come early next time. Because Jum'ah, it's about getting here on time. Unless you have a legitimate excuse. Please make room for your brothers. Jazakumullahu khair. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, when the calamity hits, and then you are patient, and you say, Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un, what is your reward? Prayer from Allah Azza wa Jalla. Wa salatullahi ala abdihi, ay, meaning Allah Azza wa Jalla praying on his servant, praising him, in the presence of the angels. Can you imagine? Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioning your name to the angels. We get happy when our name comes up on the newspaper. We buy the newspaper, even we don't buy it that day. And we go to that page and we cut the piece where my name is mentioned, and I highlight it and I put a picture frame and I hang it in my wallet at home. Because you see, my name was mentioned in the local newspaper. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. This is Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioning your name. Because of what? Because you remembered Him. فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. Remember me, He said, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I will remember you. Subhanallah. وَالْجَزَى مِنْ جِنْسِ الْعَمَلِ. Since you remembered Allah Azza wa Jal, He will treat you the same. He will remember you. He will mention your name. And then He will shower you with His mercy and He will guide you. Because of what? Because you said, Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Let's get used to say that when we are being tested. Instead of saying other stuff, let's train ourselves to say, Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Let's not deprive ourselves from this great reward. And the fourth one, he said, Ahmadu Allah Azza wa Jal, id lam takun fi dini. I thank Allah Azza wa Jalla for the fact that the calamity, it's not in my religion. Why? Because the religion is our asset and our capital. That is the thing that we should take care of the most. That's what we have. Anything else that we have in this dunya, it will stay. All we're going to take with us is where we stand before Allah Azza wa Jalla when it comes to the deen. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make dua to Allah Azza wa Jalla. What he used to say, hadith عند الترمذي رحمه الله, اللهم لا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا. Oh Allah, do not test us, do not make the hardship in our deen. Because deen is the most important thing. So as long as my deen is sound, as long as my deen is protected, then everything else, I can deal with it. For he's thanking Allah Azza wa Jalla for the fact it's not in his deen. You know how many people are being tested in their deen? Some, there are on innovation, wal-iyadu billah. Some, there are on shirkiyat, wal-iyadu billah. Others, there are on misguidance, wal-iyadu billah. Others, there are astray completely. And Allah Azza wa Jalla blessed you with deen al-Islam. Thank Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. As long as your deen is protected. I'll finish with this statement. حاتم الأصم رحمه الله قال مصيبة الدنيا أو مصيبة الدين أعظم من مصيبة الدنيا ولقد ماتت لي بنت فعزاني أكثر من 10,000، وفاتتني صلاة الجماعة فلم يعزني أحد. Didn't we say that deen came to change the way we look at things? Hatim al-Asam, one of the known zuhad, may Allah have mercy on his soul, he said, the calamity or the test of the deen is greater than the test of the dunya. Because anything that is worldly, we can deal with it. But the deen is precious, is important to us. So as long as our deen is safe, then it's okay. Any other calamity, welcome. And we will follow the four guidelines. Then he said, I lost a daughter of mine. 10,000 people came to give me condolences. And then I missed one prayer in jama'ah. And no one gave me the aza, the condolences. What does it tell you? For him to miss one salah in jama'ah is more important than losing his own daughter. Ibadallah, we have Muslim brothers and sisters who don't even pray. This man, he felt that he is tested with a musibah because he missed one prayer in congregation. We don't even pray. And we don't feel nothing. But let's promise Allah Azza wa Jal, since today, that's going to change. Because it's all about determination. Once we decide something, let's make sure that we stick to it. Today is a new start for me with Allah Azza wa Jalla. If I'm being tested with a hardship, guess what? I'm going to be patient. I'm going to remember Allah Azza wa Jalla. I'm going to thank Him that it's not worse. And then I'm going to thank Him that it's not in my religion. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqan warzuqna ittiba'ah. Wa arina al-batila batilan warzuqna ijtinabah. اللهم اجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون احسنه اولئك الذين هداهم الله واولئك هم اولو الالباب اللهم ات نفوسنا تقواها وزكها انت خير من زكاها انت وليها ومولاها اللهم انصر اخواننا المستضعفين في مشارق الارض ومغاربها يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر اخواننا المستضعفين في فلسطين اللهم انصر اخواننا المستضعفين في سوريا وفي بورما وفي كشمير وفي كل مكان اللهم انصر اخواننا المستضعفين في اليمن اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان عباد الله إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وأقم الصلاة